friends, welcome back to my channel and a very special welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on WW Personal Points. Happy Friday. It is Friday, so it is another weigh-in, the WW workshop topic recap, and I'm going to share with you guys all about my week. There are a lot of changes that have been happening this last week, and I'm excited to share them with you. So if you can't wait for another Friday weigh-in workshop topic and how my week was, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not, because we do a weigh-in every Friday, and I upload 5 videos per week. Don't forget to check out the description box down below for nutrition coaching. I do offer personalized macros and calories. I can't recommend this enough. This is how I've lost almost 130 pounds, as well as one-on-one coaching if you would like to chat with me directly. Links, discounts to my favorite things, and of course, come join our Facebook group. We would love to have you. So let's jump in to today's video. I hope you had an absolutely amazing week. I had a great week. Lots and lots of changes this week, things that I've been thinking long and hard about and decided to go ahead and bite the bullet, and I can't wait to share those with you guys. If you saw Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day, you saw that that morning, instead of doing my usual gym routine of walking to the gym, doing upper body, walking home, I actually attended a boot camp in my community called Rancho. There is the Rancho Boot Camp. They actually meet Monday through Friday at 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. or from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. And it is a boot camp style of workout. Now, the workouts vary day to day. There's some total body workouts, upper body, lower body, and then on the weekends, they often do hikes that you can participate in if you would like. I heard about this boot camp several months ago, but I had already hired my fitness coach, Steph, and didn't want to invest both in a fitness coach and in boot camp when I can use the gym here in my community at no extra charge other than my flat HOA. So I had opted just to stick with Steph, my fitness coach, and do the workouts that she gave me. I have been with her for 5 months. I can't believe I've had a fitness coach for 5 months. I can't believe that I have been on my fitness journey for 5 months. Now, I can believe it in my body and my sizing and how toned up my body has gotten, which I am so grateful for, but I can't believe it's already been 5 months. It actually blows my mind how quickly the time went. Now, don't get me wrong. I love the accountability of having a fitness coach. I love that she structures my workouts for me. She talks me off the ledge when I'm on the ledge, especially when it comes to the scale. But to be honest with you, I'm getting a little bit bored with my workouts. I have been doing the same routine now for 5 solid months, walking to the gym, lifting upper body weights, doing the elliptical, doing lower body weights, walking, which don't get me wrong, I love walking, I love working out, I love strength training. I definitely don't want to quit any of those things. In fact, I just want to change it up a little bit. I want to amp up my workouts. So after thinking long and hard, I decided to make some changes when it comes to my fitness routine. So my 5 months is up with Steph, my fitness coach, as of the 17th of October. And after going to the boot camp class on Wednesday, I decided to go ahead and join the Rancho boot camp, and I plan on doing the boot camp 3 days a week, and the remaining 4 days of the week will either be strength training or walking or both. I'm still planning on walking to the gym, doing strength training, walking home. I'm still planning on taking my walks around my community and taking a walk or having a rest day on Sunday. So I just decided to swap out my elliptical workouts with the Rancho boot camp 3 days a week. I'm getting in a little bit different workout, a total body workout on a couple of the days that I choose to do the boot camp every week, but I'm also meeting other women in my community, which is really important to me because we just moved here back in March and I really don't know anybody other than my neighbors who are my friends, my in-laws, and my realtor. So this is a great way for me to branch out and meet other women in my community and like-minded women, women who enjoy fitness and exercise. And in fact, on the 22nd of this month, I'm going to a little ladies' night with all of the girls from the Rancho boot camp. Well, girls and one guy. There's one guy in the boot camp as well. So because I decided to make the investment in the boot camp, I decided not to renew with my fitness coach for now. I want to give the boot camp a solid month. I'll kind of reevaluate at the end of November how I'm feeling. Do I want to continue with the boot camp, or do I want to go back and have do I want to hire Steph again and have her be my fitness coach? I can do my own macros and calories. I've got my workouts nailed down. I know how many reps and what weights and what exercises to do on lower body and upper body days. I just needed a change. I especially needed a change in cardio because we know I don't love the elliptical. I don't love it. It's probably my least favorite part of working out, but I know that cardio is essential. So I thought that a boot camp would be pretty fun. After my boot camp workout on Wednesday, on Thursday, I had to take a Tylenol. I was that sore, and not just a little sore. Every limb on my body was sore. My arms, my legs, my butt, my feet, everything was sore from that workout. It was so intense, but it felt really good when I finished, and I was really proud of myself that I was able to make it through it. Running, burpees, squats, and all. I made it through that workout, and I'm hoping that it doesn't get easier per se, but I'm less sore as time goes on. I'm just using different muscles than I did with my previous workouts. So I'm really excited about this change. It's a big change for me. It's another big investment, but like I always say, just like nutrition coaching, one-on-one calls, personalized macros and calories, joining a gym, hiring a trainer, those are all investments in yourself that pay off big time. So the money isn't the issue. I just wanted to change up my workouts a little bit. So I'll definitely keep you guys posted on how it goes, but I'm pretty excited. My food choices this week were really good. I was able to get in my water every day. I've been utilizing my electrolyte supplements and my Element electrolyte supplements and my 6 a.m. run post-workout. That has really saved me from these boot camps, especially my Element electrolytes. Those have been big game changers for me when it comes to refueling my body after my workout. When we sweat and when we work out, we go through a lot of the stored electrolytes in our body and we need to replenish them. And having the Element electrolytes in my life has been a huge game changer for me.
I love having my Element electrolytes when I get home from my workout. They have really changed the game when it comes to recovery and muscle soreness. It's a truly meaningful dose of electrolytes in a science-backed little ratio packet. There's 1,000 milligrams of sodium, 60 milligrams of magnesium, and 200 milligrams of potassium. They are vegan, paleo, and keto friendly. Everything you need and nothing you don't. No sugar, no gluten, and no sketchy ingredients. You can purchase them by the box or these little travel packs that have one of each different flavor of electrolytes in them. That way you can try out the different flavors, find your favorites. The chocolate salt is amazing in coffee for that chocolate goodness, and the raw unfiltered has zero taste whatsoever. So you can literally mix it into your water. So I put the packet in my water, fill it up with my big gallon jug. I love to add lots of ice, shake it up, and sip on it. It tastes really good. The flavor is there, and it's not overly salty. I love, love, love it.
I've shared Element electrolytes a few times here on my channel. You guys are loving them. They taste really good and they help balance out the electrolytes that we all need day to day, whether we're working out or not. So I'll make sure that I link Element down below for you. I can't recommend that electrolyte supplement enough. Before I jump into this week's weigh-in, let's talk about this week's WW workshop topic. And this is a good one. A lot of my coaching clients tell me that they don't eat breakfast, and breakfast is really important. Did you know that breakfast stands for break, fast? When we sleep, we're fasting. We're not consuming food, so it's a state of fasting. And when we wake up in the morning, we need to break that fast with breakfast. So this is how to make breakfast work for you. The jury's still out on whether or not breakfast is the most important meal of the day, but it is important to break your fast after sleeping in a healthy way with a good, solid breakfast. Here's how to take your mornings from chaos to calm when it comes to breakfast. Number one, decide on the basics. I'm going to eat my first meal when, at where. So if breakfast isn't for you, cool. Focus on whatever your first meal of the day is. Number two, make a plan. I want to eat this and use this many points or calories, and I'll shop for these ingredients when. Sure, you can stick with classic eggs and oatmeal, but even dinner leftovers are fair game for breakfast. Search the WW app for even more inspiration. Number three, prep your meal. I'll get my ingredients together when and cook them when. These don't have to be the same every day. Make a single meal, batch cook for an entire week, or don't cook at all. Overnight oats, please. You can make breakfast one of the simplest meals of the day and one of the best meals when it comes to breaking your fast and starting your day off right. Not to mention, by having a healthy breakfast, it gets your metabolism burning and boosting for the day. If the only thing on your breakfast menu is coffee, please rethink that. I have coffee every morning, you know that. I have my four shots of espresso with my protein shake, but that's not my breakfast. That's like my precursor to breakfast. I usually have that first, and then an hour or two later, sometimes after my workout, have a healthy breakfast. You also don't have to eat breakfast the minute you get up. It can be an hour or two after you get up, but make sure you're fueling your body in the morning to jumpstart your metabolism and so that you're not going into your next snack or meal ravenously hungry, therefore overeating and kind of blowing your day first thing in the morning. Skipping breakfast doesn't necessarily inhibit your weight loss, but it isn't the best choice when it comes to getting your metabolism going for the day. And like I said, you don't have to eat first thing in the morning. Just make sure within an hour or two after waking that you're putting something of substance in your body. It really just helps set a healthy tone for the day, which can have a ripple effect through the rest of the day. When you start your day off with a healthy breakfast, you tend to eat healthier meals through the rest of the day because, again, you're not going to the next meal as snack or snack ravenously hungry. You fueled your body first thing in the morning, got your metabolism going, and that leads to healthier choices throughout the day. So make breakfast a priority. Even if you don't love breakfast food, nothing's off limits when it comes to breakfast. Choose something you like, but find a way to break your fast and start your metabolism in a healthy way. So I really like this topic. I'm a big breakfast eater. I love breakfast food. And for me, within an hour or two after finishing my protein coffee, I'm hungry and I need something of substance, something I can chew rather than something that I can drink. So I really like this topic, and I think breakfast is one of the most important meals of the day. So now that we've talked about my new workouts, my food, my water, how important breakfast is, let's talk about this week's weigh-in. Like I said, the soreness is at a whole new level. And whenever we're sore from breaking down our muscles and our muscles rebuilding, they become inflamed and they retain fluid because they're sore. That's what helps them rebuild. And when our muscles are broken down and rebuilt, that's how they grow. So that's exactly what we want. Even though the soreness sucks, and even though the spike on the scale sucks from the soreness, it's still exactly what we're trying to get out of our workouts. So I didn't have a lot of high hopes for my weigh-in this week. My weight did a lot of this, and then a tiny bit of this, and then back to this, and a lot of this. So it was a lot of up and down all week. After my boot camp workouts, after lifting weights, my weight always goes up. And then generally it will stabilize and then generally go down by Friday's weigh-in. So this week was a little bit of an exception just because I started a whole new workout routine with a whole new level of soreness that when I stepped on the scale today, I am down 0.2. I honestly expected the scale to be up because I did boot camp yesterday. So I thought for sure that the scale would be up today. Luckily, boot camp on Thursdays is upper body day, so it wasn't as intense as full body day. That may be why I benefited with a little bit of a loss this week on the scale, but I'll take it because I feel really good and I'm proud of myself for starting a harder exercise routine. We should always progress in our fitness, whether it's a harder cardio routine, heavier weights, more reps. We should always be progressing in our fitness routine, and that's exactly what I did, and I'm really proud of myself for making that choice. And I'm proud of a 0.2 loss. Nobody's complaining about a 0.2 loss. So now I want to hear from you. Let me know, how was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? Do you eat breakfast? And even give us some ideas of what your go-to breakfast options. I'd also love to hear from you if you attend boot camp and what you think. If you think it's as hard and as crazy as I think that it is, let me know all of the things down below. And of course, if you enjoyed today's video, give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed because I do a weigh-in every Friday and I upload 5 videos every single week. Check out the description box down below for nutrition coaching, as well as links and discounts to my favorite things. Happy Friday, friends. Happy weekend, and I'll see you all in tomorrow's grocery haul. Bye.